Good evening. I'm Major Mark Partee, Director of the Education and Training Section. On behalf of Police Commissioner Daryl D'Souza, I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you to the graduation of the Baltimore Police Department's entry-level class 2017-02. I ask that you please welcome. I ask that you please remain standing and greet our honored graduates. The Academy colors are borne by Officer Arthur Williams. The national anthem will be presented by Detective Nigel Rose.
Command, class, detail, ready, face, present, two.
Rest.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so
we will begin with an invocation given by Police Chaplain Rabbi Chesky Tannenbaum. You may be seated.
Good Father in heaven, as we celebrate today the graduation of the Baltimore Police Department Class 1702, we ask of you to grant them success, grant them safety, and grant them courage. We pray together for God's blessings upon this graduation ceremony, and we ask of you, dear God, to give our police officers the wisdom to know what is right and good, and the strength and courage to meet all challenges. The Jewish tradition tells of seven universal laws that God gave to mankind through Noah, one of which directs us to create a peaceful and moral society governed by law. Almighty God, grant these public servants success in all their endeavors. To the families of our men and women of the BPD, we ask of God to continue giving you strength and blessings, as your support is vital to the job they do on a daily basis. The Lord is for all, and in Him we believe, and to Him we pray. Let us say, Amen.
At this time, it is my honor and privilege to introduce the 50th mayor of the city of Baltimore, the Honorable Catherine Pugh.
Good evening. First, let me offer my congratulations to this wonderful class. I was there for your gun and badge ceremony, and now I get to see you all cross another milestone. I could not be more proud. On behalf of all of the citizens of Baltimore, I say thank you. You have chosen a most honorable profession, one that serves as an ambassador for our city. For many of the citizens who live in Baltimore and for those who come to visit, you will represent ambassadors for Baltimore. I remind you of the pledge that you will take to protect and serve our community. Let me also remind you that as police officers for the city of Baltimore, we bestow a lot of trust and faith in you. You come into this department at a very difficult time when police officers are being judged all across our country. With the advent of social media, we're being watched every single day. And so I ask you all to remember your training, that you are trained to be constitutional police officers, that you're also trained to de-escalate violence. You will not be judged by the number of arrests that you make, but by the care and kindness that you exhibit towards others in our community. So I ask our parents, friends, spouses, to remember that when they leave their homes as officers of Baltimore City, while your heart goes with them, so do ours. And so I ask that you continue to pray for them, to bless them, and to remind you all of the profession that they have chosen. And I also want to say to you all that we look forward to your serving the citizens of Baltimore, because we know that you chose this career, and so that you will also choose to serve with honor. So I bestow upon you my prayers and my blessings, and I ask you all to go with God. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. It is now my honor and privilege to introduce the Police Commissioner of the Baltimore Police Department, Commissioner Daryl D'Souza.
Good afternoon. You guys ready? So let me say a few things first. I'm going to introduce somebody to speak as a keynote speaker. It's not on the program, but I'll introduce this person in a couple of seconds. But I want to say this. I want to say that your class is very unique for several reasons. Number one is that this is my first graduation being confirmed as the police commissioner here. You guys are the first class. I have a lot of expectations for you. Expectations is going to be higher than any other class, period. Number two is that this class is very special because you guys went through a unique challenge right as you started the academy, and I believe that you saw the video a little bit earlier. You may not have seen the video, but family, did you see the video?
Yes.
Did it touch you guys in a special way?
Yes.
And that's what we are. We're Baltimore City Police Department. That's what we do, and I'll get to that in just a second, but I realized that when you started the academy, your hearts were heavy. I'm talking about the Puerto Rican officers that are here. Raise your hand, please. But you had a unique challenge as you started the Baltimore City Police Academy. Your family members, friends, were back home in Puerto Rico, and it was Hurricane Maria that was there. And what you guys went through in that auditorium at the Public Safety Academy, I saw the tears in your guys' eyes, and it really touched all of us in a certain way, just to make sure that you guys had the support that you need in your 9 months as a police department, as a police officers, excuse me. The third thing I'm gonna say is that there was a challenge when I came in and when I was appointed. There was a challenge with some conversations centered around constitutional policing. And you may or may not heard what I said before, but we are going to be a police department, a 21st century police department that's going to respect and honor and protect the Constitution of the United States. I think that's in your oath. And you guys are going to remember that from day one to your day when you retire within the police department. I'll say a couple of other things also that about a week ago, I went to the Southeast District, Eastern District Officer of the Year Award ceremony. Southeast here. Captain Brown is here with us. And they honored two police officers, but one police officer I want to talk about that really, I need you guys to be him. Ladies, men, I need you guys to be him. And what he said when he received his award, he got up, it's Officer Jonathan Harris, he got up, and he received his award. I'm not sure if you know him, I'm not sure if he's here today, to be honest with you. But he received his award, and when he said what it meant for him to be a police officer, he said something very simple. He says he takes pleasure in getting out of his police car. He takes pleasure in walking the community. He takes pleasure answering calls for service, all while everybody on his post, everybody in the district where he works in the community, knows him by his first and last name. And that's my challenge to you guys, is when you go on the streets and whatever district you belong to or you go to, because we're going to circle back and check that the community needs to know who you are. They need to know you by your first and last name, not by a badge number. Right? Not by a sequence number that you put on a piece of paper, a 309 form that you guys probably have practice filling out. They need to know you by your first and last, and you need to make relationships as you do that, because that's mission critical for us. Judge Bedard, he oversees the consent decree. Madam Mayor, myself, other members of the command staff went before him a few days ago, and he used an analogy here, and he said, the Baltimore City Police Department has a leak in the roof. He said, you can't put a coat of paint and expect to fix the leak. He said, you can't put stucco, you can't put concrete, you can't put a Band-Aid or chewing gum in that leak to make it look good. He said, we gotta fix it. So my response back to my team is that we're not just gonna fix the leak, but we're gonna tear the entire house down and we're gonna rebuild it. And when we rebuild it, it's gonna start with you. And my expectation is for you to rebuild this house, and how you rebuild this house is by constitutional policing. And that's my expectations of you. We have seven principles, seven pillars in the police department you're gonna learn very soon. Seven pillars are crime reduction, the consent decree, internal identity, I'm gonna get back to that in just a second, I'm gonna close with that. Officer safety and officer wellness, procedural justice, trust and transparency, and the last one is youth and community. But I wanna jump over to internal identity, and what that means is, who are we as an agency? Who are we? And what's our expectations for the community? We went 81 years in this police department, 81 years, from when the first African-American female was hired. Her name was Violet White. She was hired in 1937. She never ascended higher than the rank of lieutenant, and you all know what the ranks are here in this police department. She never went higher than lieutenant. And when I came in office, I felt a need, because I know, what I do know is that women are true leaders, not just in Baltimore, but in the world. Women. Give yourself a hand there. What I did was I promoted LaTanya Lewis. She was a major. I promoted her to the rank of lieutenant colonel. And that's the first time that's happened in 81 years. And when you turn... Why did it take 81 years? When you talk about internal identity, why did it? Like, who are we as an agency? We have to embrace everybody. We have to be inclusive. We have to be a very diverse police department. And ladies, I'm not finished yet. I'm not finished with promotions of women. And I'll say this to the men as well. Where's the Puerto Rican officers? Raise your hand. Or Latino officers, just raise your hand in general. Is that we have never, in the history of the police department, had a Latino male ascend higher than the rank of major. And which one of you guys are going to be that first one? Which one of you guys are going to be that sir?
Right.
That's right. That's right. So when you talk about internal identity, I'm looking for one thing. As you guys graduate today, I'm looking for one thing when you engage and go out in the streets, and I'm not looking for arrests. I could care less if you make a single arrest. It doesn't make a difference to me. What I'm looking for is for you guys to make hundreds of friends on the streets, hundreds. I'm looking for you guys to build relationships like no other, and that's my expectation. So I want to introduce today's keynote speaker. Kind of gave a little teaser on who she is, but I want to introduce, and I want you guys to pay close attention to the highest African-American female in the history of the Baltimore City Police Department, Lieutenant Colonel LaTanya Lewis.
Good evening, Class 17-2. Greetings, Mayor Pugh, Police Commissioner D'Souza, Chief Ham, Councilman Scott, command staff members, family, friends, distinguished guests, and most importantly, members of the Baltimore Police Academy graduating Class 17-2. Thank you, Police Commissioner D'Souza, for selecting me as tonight's keynote speaker. Thank you to all the family members and friends who are here to celebrate and support Class 17-2. Wow, Class 17-2. It seems like yesterday I was sitting in those same seats representing Class 96-3. 22 years later, I have the honor and the privilege to speak at a graduation. Who knew? I did not see this in my crystal ball at all. You have decided to join the Baltimore Police Department during difficult times in our city. I commend you, and this shows your interest and desire to make a difference in our city. With that being said, I for one believe that everything happens for a reason, and each of you are exactly where you need to be, exactly at the right time. Robin Sharman said it best. There are no mistakes in life, only lessons. There is no such thing as a negative experience, only opportunities to grow, learn, advance along the road of self-mastery. As you transition from police officer trainee to police officer, there is great authority at your fingertips. I'm sure you know and have heard this many times before, but allow me to say it again. With great power comes great responsibility. With great power comes great responsibility. The police department's reputation has been tainted by corruption due to the illegal practices of some police officers. And I say again, with great power comes great responsibility. It is your responsibility to assist us with regaining our credibility. It is your responsibility to assist us with providing public safety by enforcing the law in a fair, impartial, constitutional way in partnership with the community. It is your responsibility to be fair and honest when making decisions and to honor your commitment to the citizens of Baltimore. It is your responsibility to speak up when you witness or are made aware of incidents of error and/or misconduct. There's an old African proverb that says, if you want to go quickly, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. I'm tasking the class of 17-2 and everyone here under the sound of my voice to come together to make Baltimore great again. God bless each of you for the courage you would display in the taking of the solemn oath as sworn officers of law and members of Baltimore Finest. Congratulations, 17-2. Put your best foot forward and make great impressions by taking control of how others see you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Commissioner D'Souza. Thank you, Lieutenant Colonel Lewis. And now moving on in our program, I would like to take this opportunity to introduce other dignitaries in attendance. We have Councilman Scott, Councilman Stokes, we have Councilman Sneed in the back, and we have other representatives from our other agencies. Mr. Kruger, is Mr. Kruger here? No, Mr. Kruger's not here. All right. So now on to the class address. Delivering the class address will be Officer Cody Creed.
Good evening. Welcome, Mayor Pugh, Police Commissioner D'Souza, Academy Director of Training, Major Partee, distinguished guests, family, friends, and last but not least, Class 1702. Thank you for coming out to witness this special moment. On behalf of Class 1702, we would like to thank and express our gratitude to our class advisors, Sergeant Gwynn, Officer Wilson, Officer Rosado, Officer Parlett, and Officer Horton. We graciously thank them for their support and their role in molding us into the officers we have become today. I'm sure we would all agree we could have not done this without them. Although there have been many trials and tribulations throughout 35 weeks in the academy, we have overcome them as a class and stuck together. The sacrifices and hard work put forth by myself, my classmates, and our families make tonight a truly special occasion, the night we cross the threshold and become Baltimore police officers. We have received the highest quality of training in firearms instruction, defense tactics, EVOC, and academics. With this training, I'm positive we are all ready to serve and protect the citizens of Baltimore City. All of the hard work, the hot days in the gym during defense tactics, the time spent in scenarios, has finally paid off. It is an honor to speak on behalf of our class. Once again, we thank our family, friends, Academy staff and advisors. We look forward to serving the great city of Baltimore. Thank you.
Thank you. So I'm going to go off script for 1 second and acknowledge Commissioner Hamm. I don't want to get put out of the Baltimore City College Alumni Association, so I have to make sure that I say hello to him. City forever. Thank you. All right, moving on. At this time, we will present awards that are earned during the Academy. We would like to present the award for academic excellence. This is presented to the class member with the highest overall academic average. The Academic Excellence Award for Class 2017-02 is presented to the two officers with a 94.1% average. Officers Charles Kane and Cody Creed. Our next award is the Firearms Champion Award. This is presented to that member with the highest overall average during firearms training. The Firearms Champion for Class 2017-02 with an average of 99.1%, Officer Brianna Ruiz. Next, we would like to recognize the Skills Champion. This award is presented to that member with the highest average placement in the categories of defense tactics, physical training, and emergency vehicle operations. The Skills Champion for Class 2017-02 with an average of 94.88%, Officer Arthur Williams. All right, Commissioner, you're going to have to stay right there for a second. The next award is the Police Commissioner's Award of Excellence. This award is based upon academic achievement, professional attitude, appearance, ability to supervise, and those characteristics that comprise the professional police officer. The training staff selects that member who most closely reflects these attributes. The Police Commissioner's Award of Excellence for Class 2017-02 is awarded to Officer Arthur Williams. All right, sir, since you look so comfortable right there, we're going to leave you right there for a second. Our next award is the Director's Award. The Director's Leadership Award is awarded to the member of the class who has shown outstanding leadership abilities. The class commander is assigned the daunting task of leading their class in all aspects of the academy, from when their class first arrives at the Police Training Academy to the time they graduate. In recognition of his tireless and unwavering dedication, the Director's Leadership Award is awarded to... Thank you. All right, you've been up here enough. Let's go. Our final award is the Cassidy Award. Agent Cassidy, would you please stand?
Yes, sir.
On October 22nd, 1987, Agent Cassidy approached a person that he believed had committed an assault. While conducting the interview, the subject drew a weapon and fired. Agent Cassidy was wounded and blinded as a result of the gunfire. He chose not to become a victim. Instead, he returned to York College and earned a second degree in education. He has since earned a master's degree from Johns Hopkins. Agent Cassidy returned to the Baltimore Police Department and served as an academy instructor until moving on to his position now with the FBI. This award is presented to that member who has demonstrated an unwavering commitment to inspire others. Members of Class 2017-02 selected the recipient of this award. The Cassidy Award for Class 2017-02 is presented to Officer Elise Bailey. This brings us to the part of our program long sought and well earned. Class 2017-02 will officially end their entry-level training and transition from police officer trainee to police officer. Commissioner D'Souza, it is my honor to present to you Class 2017-02.